Guys, we're going to talk about having you complete your first ever project plan. And believe it or not, this often is where people determine success. If you don't do your homework here, if you don't find great resources to help guide you, if you kind of skip this process and decide to try to play your way through things, it never works out well. And I can tell you, I've had kids test this over and over again, really intelligent kids. I watched a young man blow up a $250 engine, and I knew it was going to happen, in a matter of 10 minutes. So here's what I have to tell you. Trust me here. Do this process. And you will find not only you're going to save yourself frustration, but you're going to be happier in the end. So let's talk about how to do this, because I have streamlined it. And I know it's hard to trust me, but I don't give you busy work. This is not busy work. This is the game plan for you to be successful in trying to do something you've never done before without learning resources at your disposal. So you have to build it from ground up, right? So here's what the plan looks like. And if you notice, I've modified this. It's for 2 weeks. And so you have to be really focused on what you do here. So first, you're going to put your name, you're going to put today, you know, the date, or you can just put spring quarantine 2020 if you want to be funny. Name your project. It could just be the topic, whatever that happens to be, after you've watched things and you've kind of thought about what you want to do. In 3 to 4 sentences, explain what new information you wish to pursue. And the reason we do new information is because you're graded on how you assimilate and learn that new information, not just on product. One more time, you're graded on how you assimilate, use, and learn that new information, not just on product. So it's as if you're being graded to show your work, right? So you've got to be specific. You can't do the same old thing over and over again. You can't say, I'm going to make an iMovie project. Well, no, we've made iMovie projects. We know about iMovie. But if you explored something new, like you said, you know what, Mrs. Dink, I want to learn how to do green screen in unusual ways, and I'm going to shoot my film using this method, which is also new, that I could take. So you have to show me what you are doing that is new. That's the key. Now, here's the hardest part of the whole thing that you're going to want to run screaming into the woods. But what technical resources will you be using? For example, what software are you going to use? Are you going to use Photoshop? Are you going to use Illustrator? Are you going to use Adobe After Effects? Are you going to try to build a basic circuit, and so you're going to use an Arduino, and you're going to use some LED lights and some wiring with an IDE that you download onto your computer. What are you going to use? And so you need to have a list of stuff. Consider it like a recipe for success. Here's all the stuff I'm going to use. I'm going to use my iPhone. I'm going to use this. I'm going to use whatever you're going to do. And here's where I need to help you. You need a list of resources, considering it like a research project, a list of resources that you're going to use to guide you. And don't write here YouTube videos. If you do that, quarantine or not, I might just have to reach out and get you. Do not do that. I want you to find specific stuff. And here's where your learning comes into play. So literally, guys, remember writing the search string? It is your friend. Let's say I want to find some basic projects because I'm interested in some making circuits. So I'm going to maybe make site, instructables. Remember, X-raying a site, but site colon domain. Instructables is a great beginning tutorial site for builders. I'm going to put beginner and Arduino and circuit. And when I hit return, notice that all of my stuff comes from Instructables.com. So here's Beginner Arduino 15 Steps with Pictures, Beginner Arduino with Tinkercad Circuits, A Beginner's Guide to Arduino 15 Steps. I have a list of resources, and I'm not done. So once I find this list, let's say I want to start here and just kind of look, I have to be someone who can assess how good of a resource this is going to be. When I look at it and I read, does it have clear instructions? Does it tell me what I'm going to need? Look, says there are tons of amazing Arduino projects. So here's even more resources. And they're going to show me a lot of projects. But my job is to find specific tutorials to guide me. If, for example, I want to do something in Photoshop, I'm going to go back because it's Adobe. And our version is CC, Creative Cloud, and Adobe Photoshop CC and Beginner and Tutorials, boom, I have lists of stuff. But maybe I want just video tutorials. And if I do, remember I can use my tools and I can find when they were posted. Maybe I want them posted within the past year because I want them to be as up to date as I can. Here's a good one, Adobe Photoshop CC Tutorials for Beginners. So I can actually, I'm not done yet, I can open these and do a little bit of assessment. And what I mean by assessment is, how solid is the tutorial? This is from somebody called GraphDesk. It's got some description. I can even look at what people have said. This is an amazing tutorial. Thanks for this. You know, I can take a look at it and I'm going to listen to it a bit and see if it's in a learning style that I can understand. For Mrs. Dink, the OK Boomer in the room, I need to both see and hear my instruction. Some of you might not need someone to talk to you during instruction. You know, it depends on what you're looking for. But you will need to list. For example, if this tutorial turns out to be something I'm going to use, I would list that in my project plan. And I'm going to add a description. And I'm going to list it there. That's my job, because it's like using research in a research paper. You need to have that research available, and it needs to be something you refer to. Good tutorials are not easy to find. And I'm going to tell you that my kids share the best ones amongst themselves. For example, we know that Blender Guru is the best tutorial for Blender out there. And we will tell each other that without a doubt. Keep in mind that I'm not sitting with you to guide you through this. And your things that you're learning cannot be played their way through. You must have a game plan of learning. So I would have one over maybe something beginning. I would cover some tools, and I would know what I'm going to learn and what I'm going to build. So what's your learning goal in this process? Your learning goal is going to be, what is that new learning going to do for you? For example, in Photoshop, I'm going to learn how to cut things out. I'm going to learn how to use brushes, and I'm going to learn how to create elevated bitmap things, you know, whatever I'm going to do. I'm going to have that goal there. Each week, I must then break down. So week one, I am going to cover these three tutorials that I have, and I'm going to have some screen capture and practice that I show Mrs. Dink. Week two, I'm going to build this. I'm going to apply what I learned in a picture, and it's going to be my end project for Mrs. Dink. Always have what you're going to cover, and you can even drop those tutorials down there or tell me, and how specifically you're going to show Mrs. Dink, because this is going to be stuff you actually turn in to show me as far as progress. You can't get here and say show Dink. That sounds like something from a dog show or something, but no, you need to say, I'm going to have practice materials, screen capture actual images that I can show Mrs. Dink that I did here. And that's how you create your plan. You come up with the thing you're going to learn. You tell me how you're what you're going to cover during the week and how you're going to show me you covered it. And that is how you build a plan. I will approve it. I don't want you to try to do too much, but I also don't want you to do something that'll take you 10 minutes. I want it to be a nice balance of challenge, new learning, and your ability to conquer it all. If you have questions, come ask. Have a great one, guys. Love you much.